Hello everyone, it's John here from Winning Solutions Inc. and today I will be bringing you all another Microsoft Access Expert template walkthrough. I will be showing you where to find the template database on a website, how to download the template database demo, and how to use the demo properly. Most of our templates are not designed to be used on their own. Instead, they are designed in a way that makes it simple and smooth to integrate into an existing database that you're already using. You can also build a more robust Microsoft Access database that is built around one of our templates. If you would like to create a new database that is based off one of our templates and don't know how, or don't have the time to do so, let us know and we'd be happy to help you getting the database that 100% fits your needs. With most of our templates that we offer, there are three different versions that you can purchase: a compiled runtime version, one for internal use, and one for unlimited developer use. The compiled runtime version is a run-as-is version without the paid full version of Microsoft Access using free Access runtime from Microsoft. It can be integrated into your existing Access application, but you will not be able to make any modifications to the forms, reports, modules, etc. This option is more for those of you who don't see any need to make any customizations to the template. The internal use is a version that allows you to use or modify the databases however you wish within the organization. The unlimited developer use allows you to use the database template however you wish for any applications you develop. And it also allows you to distribute the template as part of a database you create. Winning Solutions Inc.'s templates have a strong advantage over shrink wrap software that you purchase from a store or website. With our templates, you receive the source code along with your purchase, so you are able to customize and update the database as you please. With shrink wrap software, you do not receive the source code when purchasing the software, and that means you can't update or customize the database. In our video today, we will be working with a demo version of our database template. A demo is a simple way that you can view or try out our database templates so that you can determine if you would like to purchase the database template or not. This is great for customers due to the fact that all of our sales are final. And our sales are final because we give you the source code when you purchase a template, and once we give you that source code, there's really no way you can return it. If you would like to test our demos for multiple days, you're free to do so. You just have to leave the database open so the data you entered will not be wiped. Our demos are designed so that once you close the demo, all the data entered is wiped from the database. And you have to purchase the full version if you would like to save your data that you enter. Upon downloading a demo, you have to unzip the downloaded file. And zipped files make it much easier to send and download large files over the web, so that's why we do that. Unzipping a file is very simple, though. All you have to do is extract the file so you have access to the uncompressed file. If you do not know how to do it or don't understand how to unzip a file, check out our YouTube channel and watch the How to Unzip One of Our Files video tutorial to learn this simple step. The link to that video is in the description of this video, actually. So now let us get into downloading and testing one of our own demos. All right, we're going to start off by going to our website, microsoftaccessexpert.com. On the top of the website, there is a toolbar right up here, and this is all the various ways to contact Winning Solutions Inc. And if you go over to the sidebar on the left and go under Database Templates for Sale, and then click on Database Templates List. All right, this is a view of all of our templates that we offer. And as you can see, it's broken up into categories. First one is most popular, second is appointment and scheduling, calendars, and so on, all the way down to database tools and miscellaneous templates. Today, I will be showing you the Access Personal Trainer Appointment Tracking Database Template. What you'll need to do is download the demonstration that correctly corresponds to the version of Access your computer has. Once the file is downloaded, go ahead and open it. Next, you will need to extract that file since it is in a zipped folder. So just hit Extract All. Alright, and now you'll be able to open the database without any issues. This is just a security notice that pops up, just alerting you that this database is coming from the web and it can be potentially harmful for your computer to open it, but I can assure you that this database is safe. Alright, so this is the personal trainer appointment tracking database. It's great for keeping track of appointments and all our clientele in one spot. To start, we'll do add new customer, which is right here. Okay, as you can see, there's all sorts of information that you can fill out. I'm just going to fill out a first and last name, email, and an address line for right now. So our customer is going to be called John Smith. Okay, and as you can see, you can also fill out a picture if you want to, web address, phone numbers. You can also do notes, call history, appointment history, and payment history for the customer. But these three things are good enough for right now. I'll just hit save and close. Okay, and now that customer is in the database and we'll search for him next. So search customer. Okay, we can search by all of these criteria, or as little criteria as you want, but this is everything that's available. I'll just do last name, so his last name is Smith, okay, and then hit search, and it brings up that customer that we just created. From here you can double click it, and it'll bring up the customer form again with all the same information, and you can edit any of this or delete the customer if you want to, just by hitting that. I'll just hit cancel for right now. And we can also export the search results to Excel. And I'll show you what that looks like real quick. So it opens up a new workbook for you and pulls all of that information into the workbook. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do is add an appointment. And to do that, go to calendar view. All right, this is today's date, June 2nd, 2016. To switch days, you can just go left or right arrows. So there you go. And then if you want a specific day, you can just hit the up arrow and it'll bring up the mini calendar and you can choose whatever day you want to. But we'll just stick with today. And we'll make an appointment for noon. To do that, just double click on this time slot. All right, and then for client, we'll choose John Smith, the one we just created. And trainer, let's just do trainer one for right now. But we can change any of these that we want to, and I'll show you how to do that later. Same thing with type, you can change any of these. We'll just do individual for right now. And location, location one. So appointment details, we can add notes if we want to down here. Okay, and we can change the start time and end time to whatever we want. We'll just stay with noon for right now, noon to 12:30. And workers, we can add more of those, and payment information. Okay, but for now, we'll just do select custom color, and we'll make this blue. So it'll show up blue on the appointment form, and it'll be blue on the calendar after we save and close. So there you go. And that really helps out when there's a lot of appointments back to back, and you need to distinguish between appointments so you can change different colors so you make it organized and it looks pretty appealing. Okay, and so this is just the day view. We can also view the calendar and weekly view, bi-weekly, month, and month day. Okay, perfect. All right, and we can also view the calendar by a specific trainer. If you want only the appointments for trainer 1, you can just do that. And trainer 2, likewise. Alright. Okay, and the next thing we're going to do is search for that appointment in the database using the search function. Okay, you can search by any of these criteria up top. We'll do trainer So trainer one, and then hit run search. And there's that appointment that we just created. From here, you can double click on this and it'll view it in the calendar form. Okay. So there you go. And we can also double click it to view an appointment form just by selecting this up here. Okay. So you can just look at the appointment form immediately and delete anything that you want to delete and change anything. All right, you can also export the search results to Excel. You can also export it to Alloc Calendar or Alloc Task. And you can also do a print detailed version or a print summary version. And we'll take a look at that real quick. So here's print detail. It takes up two lines on the page for each appointment. And if you want to look at print summary, we can do that. And this will just take up one line, a little less information on there. Okay, and we'll close out of that. And the next thing we'll do is take a look at maintenance lookups. Okay, and so we saw location, service type, and trainers in the appointment form. All this other stuff is all over the database. We'll just do location for right now. So we can change any of these locations to whatever we want, and we can also add locations if we want to. And then hit close down here. It'll save automatically, so don't worry about that. And just so that we saw that it changed, we can pull up the appointment form again and look at location. And there you go, location one changed to Ames, Iowa, and we also added New York. So perfect. All right, the next thing we'll do is take a look at calendar setup. Here's where you can change all the parameters of the calendar, such as first day of the week. We can change that to Sunday. And start time of each day, end time, same concept. We can also change the colors of the calendar by hitting these palettes over on the right. Then hit save and close when you're done. So the last thing we'll take a look at is reports. You have to choose a start date and end date. So we'll do that. Second, and we'll do 2 weeks from now, the 16th. Okay, and then we'll hit print invoices. And you can also do accounts receivable and a cash ledger if you want to. So here's what the print invoices looks like. Since that appointment that we created was within that time parameter, it will show up on the invoice. And invoice amount is $50 and a bunch of other information. So there you go. And that's pretty much all there is to this database. I'm going to go ahead and thank you guys for taking your time to watch this Microsoft Access Expert Template walkthrough. Brought to you by Winning Solutions, Inc. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please feel free to give us a like or subscribe to our YouTube channel for tons of other walkthroughs and tutorials. As always, feel free to contact us for any of your IT needs, whether it be programming needed, you want to buy a template, or need help customizing a template. Contact us whenever you'd like. I'm going to go ahead and post our contact information in the description below of this video. Also, you can find us on about any social media website. Feel free to follow us or like us on any of those, and have a great day.